everybody, welcome to 1-1 Coco. Tonight we are in Levera, St. Patrick, Grenada. It's in the very north of Grenada, and we are heading down to the beach to see turtles nest, more specifically leatherback turtles. They are the largest species of turtles in the world. We're hoping that one or two would come in tonight and grace us with their presence. So I hope you would join me for this beautiful experience that we expect. They're an endangered species, and that is why all of these precautions are being taken in order to see them. So we have to get permits. People are not allowed on the beach during the nighttime periods. It's patrolled to prevent that, you know. So we're heading down, and I hope you're going to have a wonderful experience with me tonight. We're not allowed to do flash photography. It affects the turtles, right? So I'm hoping to get you some good footage. Yeah, it's gonna be good. We have quite a large group in tonight. We waited 2.5 hours at the northern end of Levera Beach until we got the go-ahead to move down to where the turtles were nesting. When we got there, the turtle had already dug its hole and deposited all of the eggs and so on. So all we saw at that point was the turtle covering up the hole and trying to disguise the area to prevent, you know, predators from getting to the eggs. Fortunately though, another turtle came up at that time, and so we were able to see the whole process where the hole was being dug, and it was about two feet deep. We were able to see that turtle, second one, lay the eggs in the hole. You would notice though that there is someone removing the eggs from the hole. From what we were told by the researchers who were there from Ocean Spirits, is that the chamber was caving in. So we could kind of see sometimes where the sand was falling into the hole. So they removed it and it was re-nested, meaning that the eggs were then put into a hole that was dug by hand a few feet away. So I did see that, even though I don't have it on record, I did see them doing that. I think the reason for removing it though is that the egg shouldn't be too close to the surface, because if it is too close, then it is subject to being eaten by predators and so on. So they were removed for that reason. Look carefully at the turtle's shoulder. You will notice that it matches the action of pushing out the eggs at the back. Now, it is at this time while it's nesting that we are allowed to touch the turtle. We cannot touch it before because we don't want to give it any excuse not to leave. And we cannot touch it after because we might just get hit with some sand. So at this time, we were able to feel that leather. Afterwards, the turtle then proceeded to cover back the hole, and it was so interesting because they were using the front flippers to throw sand towards the back where the hole was, and then they would use the back flippers to kind of disperse the sand around. Added to that, they would then pivot their bodies to the side and then repeat the same process with the front flippers and the back flippers until they are satisfied that the hole has been covered. Not only that, they then camouflage the nesting area by covering it with a lot of sand. I mean, it was just amazing to watch the entire process happen. And so if you have a chance, make sure and go to see this thing. I mean, it is amazing. When I got there, I was like, oh my God, I never realized that these turtles were so huge. You read about it, but there is nothing that can be compared to seeing it in person, in action. Once Mr. Leatherback is satisfied that everything is in order, then it descends into the water. And these turtles can lay several times in one season. So it is very likely that the ones that we saw on that night would return again to lay between now and July. Head on up to Levera to catch the turtle nesting. And you might just get a 2-for-1, meaning turtles laying and turtles hatching, because the first set that will lay will begin hatching within 50 to 70 days after. So check them out. So I will post a link for Specto, which is the organization that puts together all of these turtle tours.
Big up the two guys. This is one of the two guys. I don't even know his name. What's your name,
Devontae?
Devontae, yes. It was a great scene. I'm glad I came. I'm glad I sacrificed. It was a very expensive turtle, but it's okay. It's all in the name of fun and experiences. See you next time for another episode of One One Cocoa.